To recap, we have learned what is stock and origin of the stock in the previous section. Today, the focus of my presentation is to give you a better understanding of the current stock market and explain how it works. Now let's begin. How does the current stock market work? IPO, which stands for Initial Public Offering, launches the company onto the official public market, where any company or individual who believes the business could be profitable might buy a stock. Buying stocks makes investors partial owners in the business. Their investment helps the company to grow. However, if investors think their stock value is going to decline, they'll sell their stocks with the hope of making a profit before the company loses more value. As stocks are sold and demand for the stock goes down, the stock price falls and with it, the company's market value. Unfortunately, this can leave investors with big losses unless the company starts to look profitable again. The seesaw of supply and demand is influenced by many factors. Companies are under the unavoidable influence of market forces. If supply is larger than demand, price is going down. If demand is larger than supply, price is going up. That was just basic economics. Such as the fluctuating price of materials, changes in production technology, the shifting cost of labor, investors may be worried about changes in leadership, bad publicity, or larger factors like new laws and trade policies. Of course, plenty of investors are simply ready to sell valuable stocks and pursue personal interests. All these valuables cause day-to-day noise in the market, which can make companies appear more or less successful. And in the stock market, appearing to lose value often leads to losing investors, and in turn, losing actual value. As more people educate themselves about this complex system, they too can trade stocks, support the businesses they believe in, and pursue their financial goals. Which one is better, Coke or Pepsi? I would like to compare Coke and Pepsi on a number of different criteria. First, in terms of product, Coca-Cola owns many brands including Coca-Cola, Sprite, Fanta, and so on. Pepsi owns Lay's, Mountain Dew, and also snacks like Doritos and Cheetos. The snack food opportunities as a big positive for Pepsi. And it has helped them to grow faster than Coca-Cola. I see that as a point for Pepsi over Coca-Cola 4. Coke, almost 100% revenue comes from beverage sales. On the other hand, Pepsi creates 54% sales from other than beverage. Now, as you can see, the world prefers to drink Coca-Cola or Pepsi. There is no debate, Coca-Cola wins almost everywhere outside the US, Canada, and a few other countries. And we all win if you take a moment to. They are dominating the market. However, based on 4weekmba.com, as you can see at the bottom, revenue for Pepsi was $63 billion compared to Coca-Cola's $35 billion. Net income was 4 times more for Pepsi than Coca-Cola. So then, which is the better company in terms of investment? So Pepsi individual stock purchase actually gives you a bigger piece of company. Each one is a never sell long-term play with dividends. I am a dividend investment, and for that reason, I always consider how much money I would make if I was also receiving and reinvesting dividends, given both companies pay a dividend. What if we consider how much money we would make with the reinvestment of dividends? So I would like to use different approach regarding which company's current market price is attractive to me. Here we have dividend yield comparison. Dividend yield is simply dividend divided by current market price. So if market price goes down, yield goes up. And reverse is true if the market price goes up, yield goes down. So simply comparing current dividend yield with the average dividend yield in past 5 years average helps us to figure out when a stock is priced low and when it's priced high. If you look at the dividend yield for Coke, today is 3.52% and 5-year average dividend yield is 3.19%. So current dividend yield is greater than the average dividend yield. The stock is undervalued. Now take a look at Pepsi. The dividend yield for Pepsi today is 2.81% and 5-year average dividend yield is 2.84%. So current dividend yield is less than the average dividend yield. The stock is overvalued. So as of May 27th, Coca-Cola is included in my portfolio. I purchased 10 shares with purchase price $46.64. I purchased Apple and Microsoft stock today as well. So I would like to share my investment ideas for Apple and Microsoft stock in next time. They're my favorites. As you remember, I purchased Virgin Galactic stock and it increased by 13.6%. Wow, that's incredible. Like I said, what I'm going to do is to keep updating my stock portfolio and share my investment ideas with you. Today, I've discussed about how does the current stock market works, comparison about Coke and Pepsi, and my investment ideas today. Next time, what I'm going to do is to discuss about basic terminology of stock and my new investment ideas for Apple and Microsoft stock. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and you're gonna show me some love by smashing thumbs up button and leave me a comment down there with your opinions. See ya!